Good morning students. Today we will discuss about the coordination compounds. So it is one of the important chapter in organic chemistry. Generally we will get 4 marks from this chapter. 1 3 marks question and 1 mark question. So in this chapter we will discuss about the what are the definition of coordination compounds. Some important terminology used in coordination compounds, because this in this coordination compounds we will use different terminology. So first you should learn about the terminology used in this coordination compounds. So after the terminology we will discuss about the nomenclature of coordination compounds. Nomenclature means how to give the names for coordination compounds, because there are many coordination compounds are there. So to identify the compounds, compulsory you should give the particular name for each complex. So after the nomenclature we will discuss about the isomers mean coordination compounds. Like organic chemistry, in coordination compounds also exhibit isomerism. So there are different types of isomerism is there. So we will discuss about the isomerism present in coordination compounds. After the isomerism we will discuss about the some theories about this coordination compounds. Actually, to explain the bonding and magnetic properties, color, many properties are there, different types of properties are there, coordination compounds. To explain these properties, there are many theories are there. So, but in this chapter, mainly we will discuss about the Werner theory, valency bond theory, and crystal field theory. So, after discussing about the theories, we will discuss about the bonding in metal carbonyls. That means carbonyl compounds. Generally, carbonyl compounds, some different bonding is there. So, compulsory you should learn about the bonding in metal carbonyls. After carbonyl compounds we'll discuss about the stability of the coordination compounds. So to explain the stability of the coordination compound, generally we are using one equilibrium constant. So based on that we are explaining about the stability of coordination compounds. So last one is the application of coordination compounds. After the stability we'll study about the what are the applications of coordination compounds. Otherwise, what is the importance of coordination compounds? Now we will discuss about the what is the definition of coordination compounds. So before discussing about the definition of coordination compounds, first of all you should learn some basic terms. So first of all we'll discuss about the what is meant by simple salt. Already everyone know simple salt means it is a combination of an acid and a base. Whenever acid reacts to the base, the form is salt. So this is called as a simple salt. Okay, for example, you take one acid and base. That means we take sodium hydroxide and H2SO4. So what is the product obtained in this reaction? Sodium sulfate plus water. So in this reaction, this is a base, this is a acid, so we will get a salt. So this salt is called as a, this salt is called as a simple salt. Okay, when acid react to the base, they form a salt and water, that is called as a neutralization reaction. So that is called as a simple salt. So because if you want to explain the coordination compounds, first you should learn what is meant by simple salt. Simple salt means it is a combination of an acid and base. We will get a simple salt. We will get, suppose we will take HCl plus NaOH, it is the acid and base. So we will get a sodium chloride plus water. So here also it is a simple salt. So when this is called as a simple, that means whenever when acid reacts with base, they form a simple salt. So after the learning of simple salt, we will discuss about the addition compounds. Addition compounds are molecular compounds. What is meant by addition compounds are molecular compounds? Actually, addition compounds are formed by the combination of two or more stable compounds. Before already we discussed about the simple salts. Actually, simple salt means it is a combination of the acid and base. It is one of the stable compound. So when the two or more simple salts combine, they form a additional compounds. That means additional compound means we take simple salts. Before will prepare the sodium sulfate and sodium chloride. These are the two simple salts. So when I combine the two simple salts, you will get a additional compounds. So the compounds are called as a additional compounds. See, additional compounds are molecular compounds. What is additional and molecular compounds? Additional compounds are formed by the combination of two or more stable compounds. Okay, generally you are writing stable compounds, some books they will give stable salts. Okay, some of the salts when are mixing will get a additional compounds or molecular compounds. So after the discussing about simple salt, we will discuss about the additional compounds or molecular compounds. What is meant by additional compounds? The name also indicates the addition means when two compounds are mixing, we will get one compound. That compound is called as the addition compounds. Generally, how you will get additional compounds? You should take the two stable compounds. Additional compounds are formed by the combination of two or more stable compounds. In stoichiometric ratio, means you should combine in fixed moles. Okay, that means 1 moles, 2 moles, 3 moles. That is called as the stoichiometric ratio. So when combined with the stoichiometric ratio, we will get additional compounds or molecular compounds. For example, I will take the carnallite. Actually, carnallite is the additional compound. Why it is additional compound? Because it is a combination of the two simple salts. Suppose we'll take it is a combination of the potassium chloride plus magnesium chloride plus water molecules. So it will give KCl MgCl2 dot 6H2. So this compound is called as an additional compound. Here two simple salts are there. Already I said what is simple salts. When acid and base combination will give simple salts. These are the two simple salts. When are combining, they form a some additional compounds. Okay, this is called as a carnallite. Generally, they'll ask an examination. What are the examples of what are the chemical formula of the carnallite? That is KCl MgCl2 dot 6H2. Suppose you take more salt. It is also combination of the two simple salts. More salt is the combination of the ferrous sulfate plus ammonium sulfate. Here two salts are there plus water molecules. So what are the additional compounds will get? Ferrous sulfate dot ammonium sulfate dot 6H2. So this is called as a more salt. So more salt formula FeSO4 plus more salt formula FeSO4 dot NH4 taken twice SO4 dot 6H2. This is called as a more salt. So these are called as a double salts because it is the combination of the two salts.